Good afternoon, everyone, guests of honor, honorable guests, and ladies and gentlemen. I can only speak in English. I will try to speak some in Mandarin, okay? So, Okay. So I'm from Institute of Mental Health, Woodbridge Hospital, clinical psychologist. So as soon as I mention Woodbridge Hospital, maybe some of you will have some uncomfortable feeling. So that's exactly the topic that I want to talk about. So OCD, I'm going to cover a bit about what is OCD. If time permits, a little bit about treatment. But really to talk about what is OCD. So OCD is a mental illness. Okay, so in Mandarin it's a 心理疾病. But sometimes we use the rather negative word like 精神病. And then when we say like that, it's really very, very negative. But it's quite important to understand that mental illness is actually quite prevalent. The World Trade, World Health Organization, WHO, sorry, wrong. Okay, World Health Organization says actually, statistics-wise, one in four person in a lifetime will have some form of mental illness. So one in four is actually very, very common. If you look at it, it's almost very similar to some of the medical illness that was talked about earlier. Earlier, we talked about illness of the body, like diabetes. Here, I'm going to talk a bit about the difficulties we have with our mind, our heart, and our thinking. Okay, so, and it's actually quite common, one in four. And it doesn't really just affect the person, the patient himself. It affects the family that is around us. So I thought it's quite important as one of the message that you take home is to understand not just the patient, but also understand the impact on the family. So on the point about this reaction towards mental illness, a negative stigma that goes with it, it is quite important to realize that actually it can be treated. It can be treated, and if you actually seek treatment early, the success rate is even higher. Okay, but a lot of time we have a misunderstanding about mental illness, and that makes it actually very, very difficult. So we are afraid like people with mental illness are violent, which is actually very wrong. That's not the case. Or that people with mental illness are weak, and that's not the case as well. They have a difficulty that they cannot handle. Okay. So what are the three main, three top mental illness in Singapore? So based on the mental health study done by IMH in 2010, and there will be a newer one soon, the top three mental illness are depressive, major depressive disorder, which affect 1 in 17 people in their lifetime. All right. Second is alcohol abuse, 1 in 32 people. And then the third one is OCD, which I'm talking about today, 1 in 33. All right. This is lifetime. So in the process of life, this is the percentage of people that will suffer. Now the last column is actually quite important, the average time taken to seek help. So this is a time where the person actually suffers from the illness and then to the time they actually seek help. So the longer the duration, the more difficult it is. So let me try and speak it in Mandarin. 就是这个病是这样啦,如果病况你早去看医生就比较好啦,对吗? 比较容易会 treated, okay, get well. 但是如果你越久你病了, then 越长,越长, 还没有去看医生就越难了。在心里的病就是这样, 在 OCD 方面就是九年啊，那病况开始的时候到去看医生九年，你越等越久就情况就越严重了。好 OK， So this is for the statistics of Singapore. So 1 in 10 Singaporeans in the lifetime will suffer from some form of a mental illness, not just OCD, different forms. All right. Majority of the illness actually start at age 26. So it's quite important. 情况心理疾病就开始的时候是年轻了，二十多岁有时候就开始。So the problem is this, if the illness starts early at 26, it means actually the duration of suffering is much longer. Whereas earlier we talked about some of the illness happen when we get older, mental illness may strike the person much earlier and therefore the duration is much, much longer and the cost is very, very, very high. Okay. So the burden of cost is something that, that I want to highlight here. Although mental illness is fifth up in terms of the burden of cost compared to, let's say, heart disease or cancers, right? But because it strikes much earlier at an earlier age, so actually the cost is much, much higher. So I can't re-emphasize the importance of getting treatment early. So just a bit about what is OCD. So OCD has a few components. First is about the thoughts. So there'll be a lot of different thoughts which I will mention, habitual thoughts that comes up in the mind of the patient. Second is the severe feelings of anxiety and fear, right? Thirdly is actually bodily sensations. So sometimes it's not just thought or feelings, but it's bodily sensation. So a patient ever explained to me this gao wei feeling. So gao wei feeling is, I cannot understand, I don't know the English word, but irritation, is it? So gao wei feeling, so actually it comes up in the body. So it's not in words, it's not in feelings, but it comes up in the body, it's very uncomfortable. So, and then very, very jinjang, very tense, yeah? So the mix of all these things about the thoughts, 思想啦，情绪啦，还有这些搞位的感觉，就很难接受，很难接受。So actually what the OCD patient does is that they have to do many, many compulsions. So they will repeat. So one of the most common compulsion that we hear of is wash hand, 洗手啦。Then some must align everything straight, huh?Some was checked many times, touch, right? So many compulsions with the aim of actually trying to get rid of all these sensations and get rid of all these thoughts, right? Sorry, I must press the right button. Okay, so let's talk a bit more about some of the thoughts that OCD patients have. Firstly, most common is fear of contacting a disease. So like, dare not touch, I might get sick, right?So second is actually some people are very fearful that some bad things can happen to their loved ones. So then they have to do some of the compulsions, right? Then other thing is fear of doing something like haven't switched off the gas stove. So must click many times, okay? So some of these thoughts that comes up, okay?Other things is like things are out of order. And something else which is may not be so common is the fear of saying something wrong. So like I'm standing up here on the stage and then I fear that I might say some vulgar words, right? Or some people who are very religious, they go to a place of worship, they are worried that they do something totally wrong that's against the God. Okay.All right, so many different thoughts. So it's not one pattern. OCD is many different thoughts. So we try to understand what goes on in that particular patient. I think people are getting hungry. Okay, I better speed up. Okay, so like I mentioned, many physical symptoms, sometimes heartbeat fast, tense, etc., feeling faint and so forth, right? And then other things that may happen in the mind is that so anxious, so tense that your mind go blank. So hopefully my mind don't go blank, so I can continue talking. Okay. All right, some of the compulsions, like I said earlier, there'll be checking, washing, repeating, ordering. And then something which we may not understand is something called mental compulsion. So sometimes if you see a patient with OCD and then they are like, still. Actually, what is happening is in their mind, they are replacing thoughts. Replacing thoughts, for example. So they may have a thought, a very fearful thought, like I may say something vulgar, right? So in their mind, they are mentally like trying to correct that thought. I will not say something vulgar. Yeah, trying to replace the image. So for example, they have may have an image of a very violent or sexual thought. So then they will sit there and then freeze and then try to replace that thought. So if you can imagine someone sitting there and trying to replace a thought, they cannot function, right? And then people will say, "Siaweya," and that's a terrible thing to say. Please, we try not to say those kind of things to the client. So what is happening is the mental compulsion is going on, and then they freeze, right, and not engage in life, right. So this is a bit less common. Another area is actually asking for reassurance, and this will get very irritating to the family members. So let me ask, give you an example. So the person is very afraid of the stove not switch off, right? So one of the compulsion is they will click, 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 click. Then after that, you say, "Father, come, Father, can you click for me?" Right? So once a father click, then you say, "Not my responsibility already. A father click already, ma." So that's one thing. Then another one could be like the door, lock, huh? Cannot lock, right? Mother, 你来,你关我关. Then mother quan already, then no problem. But the problem is this, right? Asking for family members. After a while, the family members get very agitated. Why you always ask me to do this and do that? So then the whole family becomes involved, not just the patient. Then everybody gets very agitated. Later on, I will explain a bit about what family members should do. Okay. Then of course, one thing is because it's so fearful and there are so many things the person needs to do, many OCD patients, if it's very, very severe, what happens is that the world gets very, very small. So initially, they may dare to step out of the house, right? But they don't go very far. And later on, they're not step out. Then finally, actually, some OCD patients get so severe, they end up only in their room. So they will only be in their bed, and they will only eat if people pass them the food. So you can see actually the compulsion makes the world smaller and smaller until it's so constricted, right? So this is an example of avoidance that goes on. So by now, if you understand OCD can be quite severe and quite damaging to the person. So a person with a good mental capacity because of this fear can get really, really restricted in their life. Okay. As you talk to someone with OCD, sometimes if you ask them about their fears, right? If you ask them about their fears, do you really believe that this is a problem, right? Most of them will actually tell you they don't believe in it, right? However, it is like all those feelings and the bodily sensations that make it impossible for them, right? So one of the most interesting point from research is that are the thoughts that OCD patients have different from the thoughts that maybe most of us have? Oh, I do get anxious sometimes. So for example, have I locked the door? Have I switched off the stove? Right? Did I clean something or things like that. So most of the thoughts that the OCD patient have is very similar to us, right? 90% of the thoughts that the OCD patient have is very similar to our thoughts. But how come some people are not bothered by it? Not that we are dirty lah, or not that we are disorderly. Just that the fear that we have may not be so, we don't respond with that kind of pathological fear, right? Then we say, yeah, I think a lot already lah, never mind. But for OCD patients, their fear is extremely high. So the difference is not in the thought, the difference is actually their response to the thought and the feeling, okay? I think I lost most of the people who speak Mandarin, but let's see. So I won't use this, this is too difficult. But I think I use this because this will explain. Alright, so 从这个思想啦方面啦，就是好像怕那些东西肮脏啊，还是怕这个安全吗？还是这个思想开始就弄到我们很紧张了，很怕了，这个情绪。也许有一些搞味的感觉，啊，所以这因为这样很难受了，对吗？很难受，就去做那个东西了，骂，还是 click 好多次了啊。所以为什么呢？做了就有点好像安定一点点了啊，但是这个安定不久了，很快又来了。我有没有讲了、啊、有没有做错事又来了、啊、就一个很大的圆圈，这个圆圈就不停的了，就好像如果你有一个小小的老虎了、小小的老虎，哇，很美啊，你就给它吃啊，对吗？吃那个老虎就越来越大了啊。这个 OCD 就是这样了、是这样，你就喂它，它就越来越大了、啊、所以情况是这样了，比较难了、啊、那可以有的救吗？一定有的救啦，没有的救我就不在这里讲了、啊、OK, before I talk about the treatment, so 重要是家人、啊、如果你家里 有一些人 有这个 OCD 的情况，要强迫症，如果有这个病况要怎么样、哦、第一 不帮助的是这样，这里了不帮助，就是说你帮他做了，哎呀，你不要骂了我跟你骂、哦啊、你不要关了我跟你关、啊、你这个 对那个病人的没有帮助、啊、也第二就是骂他了，哇，老你为什么这样的啊，为什么你这样没有力量，不可以resist 了哈，不可以你骂他，你越骂他，他的人越小啊，他想法就越弱啊，这些没有作用了。好的呢，就是说了解一下了，哦，你情况真的很难哈、哦，这样生活很难啊。那也不要说你什么也不要做了，坐在家里不可以，你最好就快点去带他去看医生啦，好像来看心理学家，还是看psychiatrist 一下、哦、不要躲在家里，但是不要心外不要骂他了，神经病啊，哇哟，这个不好啊，不要这样对人，人家对我们这样，我们也不喜欢了啊、哦、OK。好吗？可以吗？有没有帮助？好，快点带去看医生就比较好了。OK, so I think up to this point, almost lunch already. So I should really stop. Just give you a brief idea of key treatment. So at least I can wake up you, or you all can come and look for me. OK, so there are two groups of people. One is the doctor.I'm not a doctor, I'm a clinical psychologist. Okay, so in the Singapore health system, first go to the doctors. So polyclinic get a referral, and then you come to the hospital, the psychiatrist will do an evaluation first, right? So some people will only want to take medication, 吃药也, okay. So, okay, fine, if you 吃药有点帮助啦, but for OCD 强迫症很重要, 要找 心理学家, 因为 the gold standard for treatment, the gold standard for treatment for OCD is actually exposure and response prevention, right? So work with the psychologist to work so that you can slowly build up the ability to resist. Don't feed the tiger, feed yourself. So you work with the psychologist to build this resistance. Now, the earlier you seek a treatment, the faster. So I have some fairly young patient. I only work with adults, so 18 years old, like NS boys. So they come. So first I go and see, wow, you tuang la. No. They're quite serious. So NS boys come, they have OCD. So, but because they are much younger, the treatment is much faster. 8 sessions, they finish. They don't want to see me already. I said, wow, you sure or not? You still want to come and escape from a camp? Say, don't want really. Enough. So actually, if you come early, very fast, 8 sessions, right? Gold standard, actually, typically 20 sessions, right? The difficulty comes is if it's long standing and then very complex already, many other things get thrown in, then they're really stuck. Then it will take my colleagues who are running the specialized OCD clinic in IMH a much longer time to treat. So it's a combination of both medication as well as psychologist intervention is needed for both. Okay, so I will end here with just really encouraging good mental health, not just from the point of view of OCD, but good mental health. How do you say this in Chinese, in Mandarin? 就是 later, or maybe you can help me. So 就是不要乱想东西了, 想了一大堆东西, 情绪坏, 但是就, so how do we have a good mental well-being? It's actually exactly what the nurse clinician say just now. Body, mind and soul, right? Body must exercise. 要做运动啊, 没有做运动脑就很 很差了, body, so exercise regularly, right? Mind will be like if you practice meditation or mindfulness. I'm very big into mindfulness. Getting some peaceful time. Don't every day, non-stop. Cannot, right? So every now and then must stay calm, sit, breathe, right? Observe everything that's going around. So the mind. Then the soul, it depends. If you don't believe in God, then there's nothing to talk about. But for those who believe in God or goodness, then feed the soul. Feed the soul. So body, mind, and soul, overall, then your person will be much better. So maybe my translator can help me with that. So thank you very much. So, yeah. Yes.
Thank you. We have now Mr. Yang will be giving the interpretation in Mandarin.
OK, 我会很快地重复一下刚刚我们的演讲者王先生说的一些细节。 OK, 那就是今天我们的这个主题是 OCD, 就是强迫症。那强迫症是什么呢? 它是一种心理疾病, 然后也不是一种很不寻常的。 在新加坡每10个人就有一个人有曾经患上强迫症, 在他一生中。 OK, 那强迫症它这个重点是怎么样? 就是说他这一个人, 他会一直重复地去做某件事情, 因为他心里很害怕。 就是他觉得说他门没有关好, 还是他的火没有关, 他就一直去重复做这件事情。 那如果有这种症状的话呢, 那身为家人的我们应该要帮助他们, 要尽早让他们去接受治疗, 去找医生的协助, 不要就是, 觉得他们有一些精神上不正常, 就批评他们, 还是责骂他们。 对, 所以简单来说就是, 所有的心理疾病都是可以治疗的, 我们不要想说, 如果有心理疾病的话, 就应该, 就是, 对自己没有信心, 我们就是要尽早去寻求协助, 这样子就可以得到很好的改善。 谢谢。
Thank you. So are there any questions? Oh, okay. Yeah, we can take one question.
Thank you, Mr. Wong. I have some questions to ask. From the experience of the various types of OCD, which one is the most difficult to treat? OCD, you have two types of treatment. One is CBT, one is medication. So which type of treatment is more effective?
Okay.
The next one I want to ask is, what are the chances of relapse? Okay. Then the last question I want to ask is, can medication be withdrawn if a person is well and behave normally?
Thank you. It's a very important question. So all the OCD characteristics, they're all similar. So you can't really say any one of them is easier or more difficult, right? The gold standard for treatment, just now as I mentioned, is based on CBT. It's called exposure response prevention, gold standard. So it's a lot of research. If you go into all the different like US or UK medical systems, you will find that is the recommended treatment method. So, and then your third question is quite important, that OCD is lifelong. So I think in the Mandarin word is what? Man sing ji jing, right? So it's a chronic illness. So very much the same as anxiety disorder. If we have a predisposition of anxiety or being anxious, of which OCD is a part of it, it is actually chronic, meaning a lifetime. You have this as a friend. So I describe it as we have anxiety as a friend, we have OCD as a friend, meaning there will be ebb and flow. So some days it will be worse and some days it will be lower. So basically you learn the method and then you keep applying the method. So yeah, when things are well, good, mood is good, job is good, or we are successful, maybe it's less of a problem. But when it's stressful, then things are worse. But we apply the same method. We don't feed the tiger, we resist, right? But basically, we have this OCD as a friend for life, and then we not really befriend, but at least we know where they stand, right? So it's a lifetime activity. Thanks a lot.
Can you stop medication or not?
Medication is something we will monitor. Okay, so we want to make sure the person understands how to apply the CBT method, the ERP, right? Because if you have no medication and no ERP, then the person can have a big relapse, right?
Hey, thank you, Mr. Wong, for helping us to better understand obsessive compulsive disorder. Thank you.